People who don't fear him, either as a pastor or as a brother or as a deacon, as a deaconess. When you are not afraid of God, your life is at risk. I read in my Bible, God kill it. God kill it and he make alive. But that is not the cruise of the matter. The cruise of the matter is everything God speaks, he has the authority and the power to confirm. He said, God also working with them. They were not doing the work alone. God was working with them. And he was confirming the word. So I want you to pay close attention. Every word coming out of these lips of faith, as the Lord liveth, in these 7 weeks, in the name of Jesus. Can I hear your believing amen?
Amen.
Last week, I began to take you on an adventure into the school of success. My passion, my goal, my drive, my dream is to see you become greater than me. So each day of my life, I seek for means to push you upward. And then God made my mandate clearer again to me this week. Don't sit and try to rob me of the joy to do the job, but I found it back. Somebody say,
I found it back.
That's why I say I fear God. On Sunday, when I got back from Torino, he came to me in my room and he said quietly to me, Habakkuk 3:17-19, what does he say? And I repeated it to him. I said, he says, and if the fig tree does not blossom, and the olive does not yield a vine, even if the cattle don't bring forth fruit, I will yet praise him. Which means it is not what he makes happen that should determine my joy. I will yet praise the God of my salvation. Then, will he make my feet like hinds' feet, and he will cause me to rise on the high places of the earth. So I discovered Satan is trying to be an hindrance to my assignment by stealing my joy. But I found it back. May you find your own back.
Amen.
I said, may you find your own back.
Amen.
So I'm here again, fully loaded to treasure the devil. So in case you came with one, I'm a devil buster. Can I hear your amen?
Amen.
You don't need to encourage me. I'm just a devil. So anything that came there with you as a body, as a cause for worry, as the Lord liveth, on this ground of breakthroughs, they are dropping of you in the name of Jesus. And then we discovered last week what is the foundation for success. We said success is impossible. We took our anchor scripture from Romans chapter 8, beginning from verse 28. And it says, and we know that all things work together for the good to them that love God and are the called. Now, it is one thing to love God, but it's another thing to be called by God. Now, there are some people who are zealous, but yet without knowledge. Of what success should be like. So when God calls you according to his purpose, his divine intent is to translate you, change your destiny, and make you look exactly like Jesus in the picture of success. But then it is wisdom for us to find out what enabled Jesus become a success. We also establish the fact that success is not a destination. Success is not an event. It is a journey which along the way should bring lives on, but to impact is to cause a drastic change to come to play. Now, so if in my work or in my assignment as a pastor, I don't effectively touch your life, then I am not on my way to success, because I should be able to enable you recover your destiny, recover your stolen dreams, and help you pursue your dream, so you also, on the long run, why Jesus said, well done, thou faithful servant, he can say also to you, well done, thou faithful servant. Now, if I'm the only person on the last day that he tells, well done, and say, faithful servant, then I am not, on the long run, impacted your life. Successful. Now, it does not matter if I have money, I have houses. Success is not about possession. It is about accomplishment of divine assignment. That is why he said you are called according to his purpose. So now today we want to go a little step forward to look into that great thing called purpose. Now, without purpose, success is a mirage. Without purpose, success can be a hard thing to attain. Without success, you wouldn't know how to embark on the journey, because success is a journey. And if you don't know where you are going to, you hardly can tell when you arrive, nor can you tell whether you are in the right way. Now, a car driving at 200 kilometers per hour on the wrong road, we never get anywhere. So, this teaching today is to enable you get back on track. It does not matter how far you have gone on the wrong road. What is important today is after this teaching, you should be able to reconnect back on the right way and just do the right thing so you can be successful. Can I hear your amen?
Amen.
I wouldn't waste time. Jesus was a man. But let's look at this great definition of what is purpose. Now, I'll put it this way, in a very clear and concise manner, so it can help you understand it. So, now, purpose can be defined as the acknowledgement of the reason why a thing exists. Purpose defined as the acknowledgement of the reason why a thing exists. Which means, without purpose, existence becomes a body. Are you here with me? Can I hear you into that? So if we have said purpose means the acknowledgement of the reason why a thing exists, it means if we don't acknowledge the reason of anything's existence, then we can't maximize the use of that thing. I'll give you a good example. This microphone is to amplify my voice. That's its purpose. The day I begin to use it as a drumstick, it has lost its purpose. And what will happen? I can't hear you. What will happen? It will be destroyed. So, a person, an object, it's outside its original purpose, it is on its way to destruction. When a man or a woman loses the essence of existence, a man who calls himself now a woman and says he's homosexual, now he has lost his reason for existence. So there is no way he can be destroyed. So when Romans chapter 2 says, because they refuse to acknowledge God, he gives them over unto a reprobate heart. When you lose the acknowledgement of purpose, God will leave you to your own decision, and your decision can bring you very terrible woes. It means to say, if you are in existence and you live your life without purpose, you are heading for destruction. May that not be your portion in the name of Jesus. I said, may that not be your portion in the name of Jesus. Purpose is
was made or created. That's another definition. Purpose is the reason why a thing was made or created. And there is something very crucial. Please listen to me with very rapt attention. I've got very limited time. It means to say, if I want to know how to use this microphone very well, which is to amplify my voice, the best bet is to consult the manufacturer or its manual. Come on, can you hear me now? Anytime this microphone is giving me problem, the best person to produce the solution is the man who made it. Because before he made it, he had an intent at the back of his mind. I was not there when he made it. I don't know his components. Even though I am a technician, I can't know exactly what he put together to be able to make it. So to be able to have an effective use of it, I must consult the manufacturer or the creator. That means to say, you can't purpose for yourself. You must discover purpose. Many people say, I have a vision. Can I surprise you? Can I surprise you? Without purpose, there can't be vision. It is vision that, it is purpose that gives room for vision. Now, if you read in Jeremiah chapter 1 from verse 5, God was speaking to Jeremiah, before I formed thee, I knew thee. Verse 5 beginning. Before I formed thee, I knew thee. Before I formed thee, I knew thee. Which means before the man made the microphone, he knew the microphone. So it is not the microphone that tells the owner what he will do. It is the owner that tells the microphone what it should do. Before I formed thee, I knew thee and I ordained thee. So purpose is a function of divine election and not an essence of conviction. You can't be convinced. You only need to discover purpose. You can't be convinced about purpose. You discover purpose. Because if you are convinced and you are not very careful to consult with the manufacturer, you might end up being a convict. Hope you are following me. So, if I make much money and yet I am outside of purpose, I will end up being destroyed. I'll give you a very good example. I've seen millionaires, men who made money, but they took their life. Some run mad. Now, a couple of years ago, a research was done on the 7 richest men on the planet Earth. 7 richest men. And it will amaze you, the 7 men who were the richest then, they were unbelievers, they all died miserably. Some died insoluble. Which means their bankruptcy was insoluble, either by the government or by the bank. They were bankrupt. You know what it means to be bankrupt? Now, there were some who died in jail. 2 died in jail. 1 died in a mental asylum. And the remaining 2 committed suicide. But they were rich. It means to say, purpose has nothing to do with your wealth. It only has to do with your divine ordination. Now, if God created me to be a speaker or a pastor, at the beginning, he had put certain things in me that will energize my purpose. That's why you can't preach like me. You can only preach like yourself. You can't think like me. You can only think like yourself. You can't walk like me. If you walk like me, then you are getting out of your original and you are becoming a counterfeit. Now, you have to know, and when you become a counterfeit, you have left purpose. So, God's divine intent is to always make you an original. Which means, when God made you, he threw away your mold. Everything he needed for you on your day of creation, he put inside you, and no other person has anything like you. Then, when you don't fulfill purpose, you are not only disappointed yourself, you have disappointed humanity and you have disappointed divinity. Can I hear your name? The reason why we have not yet discovered purpose. Purpose. Now, many people see me when I preach, they say, oh, man of God, you preach well. I laugh at them. Before I discovered purpose, these potentials were inside me. Can I talk to you? Before I became a pastor, everything inside me was already inside me. But it is when I discovered purpose, the things inside me began to reveal themselves. Because then the manufacturer began to make a demand on what he put inside me. What I am not giving to you, I cannot ask you of it. If when he made me, he didn't put potentials to enable me to be a glorious pastor, he can't criticize me if I am not successful. Because he didn't give me anything to make me successful. But when I discover purpose, my potential are stimulated because they are born with me. Now, I didn't learn to speak the way I'm speaking. I was born with it. Now, all I need to do was to give my vocal cord some accent to release what is inside of me. But these are all functions of the discovery of purpose. Can I hear you? Now, purpose, no matter who you are, no matter your education, if not discovered, you are just a man on a way heading for absolute destruction. And I will show you two very major important things that are very crucial for you as a believer. Number one, when you are born again, you come back to God's family. I told you something last week. Adam, God made Adam. Adam is the prototype. You know what they call a prototype? Now, a prototype is the first one you make that you now look at it and use it as a semblance to make the other ones. So, Adam was God's prototype. In Italian, they call it prototipo. Now, that prototype messed up. So, because the prototype messed up, every other one made after the prototype also messed up. Is that right? Yes. If I make a shoe with a wrong measurement, and I keep on making all the shoes like that, I'm making all of them with a wrong measurement. So Adam was the prototype. He messed up. So every man like Adam began also to mess up. So Adam lost purpose. When he lost purpose, he didn't just lose purpose. He lost a lot of things. Now, he lost his relationship with his creator. He lost his power for dominion. He lost his power to multiply what God has put inside of him. And that is the dominion mandate that God gave to Adam at the beginning. Because in Genesis 1:26, God said, let us make man after our own image and after our own likeness. So God wanted man to be a success like him. But man changed his own direction because of choice. Somebody say choice. Now, your choice can make you lose your purpose. Your choice. The food you eat, the friends you keep, the words you say, the room you sleep. Now, your choice can alter your purpose or augment your purpose. Now, when it alters it, it can alter it either to destruction. Your choice. So, if I am not a cocaine user and I began to move with a cocaine user, though I'm a pastor, and he tells me one day, why don't you try it? It might be good for you. And if I make a choice to try it and it begins to destroy me, now it is my choice. Now, in many cases, we have continued to blame the devil, but it is not the devil's fault. Every day people say the devil, which devil? Man is the devil, because man, God gave him the capacity for choice. And everybody who has a choice is a devil. You either choose good or you choose evil. So it's not about the devil. So choice becomes realizable based on the platform of choice. If your choice is good, your purpose is discovered and well utilized, and you succeed. Now, if your choice is bad, you've made a wrong choice. And I'm sorry, I pray you don't make one in the name of Jesus. I've made some wrong choices. I've made some wrong friendship. I've entered some wrong relationship. But the truth is this, it does not matter where you have been. What matters is your capacity to turn back and just
But strong will and good choice is impossible. Strong will. Have you ever been a drunkard before and you try to stop drinking? Now it is difficult. Have you ever been a thief? It can be, no matter how petty it can be. Now it takes God's supernatural grace. Because if you don't have the will to stop stealing, everywhere you go, you see what others can see. And if your choice goes to steal, you keep on stealing. But don't you hear what Paul said? It is no longer I am. The things that I want to do, I can't do them. But those things I don't want to do, that I find myself doing. He said, now, who will deliver me from this wretched man? As long as you are in this body, you are a wretched man. So it needs new birth to be able to escape and make good choice by the power of the will of God. Can I hear your amen to that? But it does not stop there. Because choice and will alone can't help you discover purpose. That's why when you move forward after new birth, the next thing which is very important is you as a Christian must be filled with the Holy Ghost. Now I'll show you something very powerful here. Many of you have heard the scripture from Joel chapter 2 verse 28 to 32. Is that correct? Now that in the last days I will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh. Is that correct? And my young men shall do what? They shall see. Are you in this church? Can you talk to me? Amen to that. He said, and my young man. Now, can you put up the screen, please? Joel 2, 28 to 32. So I don't speak as if I'm speaking to moron. I'm speaking to intelligent men and women who can become more intelligent. Now, I'm speaking to rich men who can become richer. I'm speaking to prosperous men and women who can become more prosperous. So I want to be alive. He said, it shall come to pass. After all, said the Lord, that will pour out of my spirit upon all flesh. Now, the church has limited itself to the first part of that prophetic scripture. They shall prophesy. So many people are running after the prophetic gift and the prophetic office. But yet, they have left many undone, which has made many people to go out of purpose. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. So when you are born again, you are called now according to his purpose. His spirit now comes inside you and now you begin to have dreams. I've said before, this Bible is a bank of dreams. A bank of dreams where you can go by yourself and withdraw for yourself the kind of dreams you desire. Dreams. Somebody said dreams. Now, when your purpose is revealed, I said it must be discovered. Now, it's revealed to you via these methods. Dreams. Visions. Now, what we call vision, in many cases, is not vision. It's not really vision. Vision is not the purpose why you are alive. Is the reason why you are alive. Now, vision is the assignment that God gives to you. So, your purpose is what brings to birth your vision. And not vision, your purpose. But in many cases, it has been taught vice versa. That if you don't have vision, you can't find purpose. It's a lie. You need purpose to be able to have a vision. Because if I have a wrong vision, which is not in line with my purpose, then it is a vision taking me outside of God. Now, so the truth is this: your visions come out of your purpose, but this purpose is revealed through the Holy Spirit. Jesus speaking in John chapter 14 and John chapter 16, when he was speaking about the Holy Spirit. Now, the Holy Spirit had some great assignment. One of his assignment is to show you, is that correct? To reveal to you. And one of the things he reveals to you is the reason why you are alive. Why you are here. The Holy Spirit is not just sent to you to only just comfort you. He's sent to you to reveal. He will take of me and show unto you. He will take of me and show unto you. So you must know that until you are filled with the Holy Spirit, it is difficult to find purpose. Write it down, it will help you. Until you are filled with the Holy And I say, can you tell me why you were born? How many can really answer that question? Why were you born? Can you answer the question? Let me give it to you as your assignment. Go home and answer the question. Write one page full, I didn't say 10 pages, only one page full of why you were born. Don't you hear what Jesus told Pilate in the book of John? Jesus said, to this end was I born. To this end was I born. They came, the Pharisees, they came to John the Baptist. Who are you? What do you say of yourself? Who are you? What do you say of yourself? Why were you born? If you don't know why you were born, then you are a creation of accident. I can join Charles Darwin to say you are a product of evolution. That's true. Why were you born? That's the question that opens you to your purpose. Why were you born? Why are you in this world? Oh, and then you're busy struggling, looking for money, looking for basket, and you won't find any. Because your success and your prosperity, God packaged it in your purpose. Hello? Hi. Your prosperity is packaged in your purpose. If God made you to be a hairdresser, and you came to Italy until you become a hairdresser, you will be a wanderer. He that wandered away from his place. You are a wanderer. So that's the main thing. Why were you born? When you find out why you were born, you will discover the talents that are in you. Now, you are a great man. You are a great woman. You are a great boy. You are a great girl. You have so many potentials lying dormant in you. The giant never wakes up until he discovers who he is. Why did David run like a giant back to Goliath? He knew what it was. Did you see the answer he gave to them? The God who delivered them, be and their life, told me this one, forget about it. He revealed to me that I am a devil buster by enabling me to tear the lion so I know who I am. God said, yes, I found the man. God don't waste resources. God only look for people who are men of purpose. Why are you looking for money to start a business and God don't give you the money? He will never give you. Is that a curse? If he give you, what will you do with it? Is it in line with his purpose? So that's why you can pray and fast from now till forever and nothing is coming, because why? It is outside of purpose. When a man is in line with purpose, all things work together for his good. Can I show you one more scripture? I'm almost out of time. 1 Corinthians chapter 2 from verse 9 to verse 11. First Corinthians 2, 9 to 11. It says, but as it is written, I have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has it entered into the heart of man, the things which God has prepared for them that love him. Now, but man is able to make that discovery by one thing, one power, one source. Verse 10. But God has revealed unto us by his Spirit. For the Spirit does what? It searcheth. The Spirit is the satellite transmitter that transmits what God has made you to be, because you don't know your beginning, but the Spirit knows your beginning. You don't know your end, but the Spirit knows your end. So what does it do? It takes from the Father what has been kept in your personal archive in heaven and brings to show them to you, so you can now pursue your future. It takes them, show them to you, and enables you to pursue your future. Yeah! Not just normal things. The big things. That's why I told you it is beyond vision. Now, that word there in Joel 2, verse 20 to 32, is different from the one we have in Habakkuk chapter 2, from verse 1 to verse 4. There's a word of difference. Now, that vision in Habakkuk chapter 2 chapter 2 from verse 1 to 4 has to do with inquiry. But this one here has to do with inquiry. It has to do with your purpose, vision, dreams. And without dreams, you are not a man of the future. You need dreams. Dreams keep you alive. They keep passion burning in you. If not for the dreams I have about my future, many of you would have made a fire of the anointing. Now, one of my pastor friends said, the people in this country, they keep the anointing. People in this country, they just keep the anointing. So it takes the dream. Now, with all the hardship of Joseph, if not the dreams, he would have given up. So the dreams kept him going. The dreams kindled passion in him. And the passion enabled his mission. And his mission made his success. So that's the way it goes. Yeah, the deep things, the things which ordinary three eyes can't see. This one has nothing to do with word of knowledge. Does it? No. This has to do with prophecy. He said the deep things. The deep things. Now, in the realm of the prophet, we have class. Some prophets can see from realm 1 to realm 2. Some from realm 1 to realm 3. Some from realm 3 to realm 5. Then we have some that can see from realm 1 to realm 7. Now, those are the prophets who God have given grace. They can tell you with the word of knowledge, the word of wisdom, yesterday, today, and tomorrow. It's level. It's realm. It's realm. It's realm. So not always when I put name tag, prophet, forget about it, tear the tag away, ask them, what's your future? You can't tell anything. And say it's a prophet. God forbid. Can I hear the amen?
Amen.
So you must know this. Verse 11. For who can know the things of a man, save the spirit of man which is in him? Even so, come. Even so, the things of God, not no man, but the spirit of God. So, purpose is made available to you only by the Holy Spirit. Did you hear what Apostle Paul said in Acts chapter 26 when he was speaking to Agrippa? He said, oh, King Agrippa, when he came to his tent, he said, I was not disobedient to the heavenly vision. You know, we have some cooked visions, don't you know? Cooked vision. They cook it. You don't know? Abba. We have some abracadabra visions made on the beds of men and revealed to men. And we have some vision that people eavesdrop and they come to tell you. Oh, you don't know? Brotherly, it is well.
Amen.
I said it is well.
Amen.
So there's heavenly vision. Heavenly vision shows you your purpose. Now, this, because I knew I was going to teach this, I went to the Lord again. Lord, I'm on the right track. Because you can miss it. And think you are still on the right track and you just keep going. Even you increase your speed. And you are driving at 140 or 180. And God is not with you. By the time you turn your back, Lord, where are you? You say, I left you long time ago. Because you are no more on my purpose. So he redefined it to me. He redefined it to me. Made it much more clearer. Now, it took me 1 whole year, 1 year, to be able to discover the totality of purpose for me and this church. 1 year. The whole year 2007. I started from January 1 in fasting and prayer. Lord, what have you sent me to do? Give me the details. Because if you don't know the details, you will be detained. Satan has a detention car. Whoa. And many people in church are in Satan's detention camp, including pastors. Including pastors. That God says I should start another branch, and another pastor wants to start another branch. Now, the pastor can get into detention. He's running with my vision, my purpose. And then he's ministering in his own eyes. We just die. God said the pastor should build a school. Don't mean I too should build a school. Billy Graham has been preaching John 3:16 for over 60 years, and it has not, because purpose enables you to keep relevance. When
you stay in your purpose, you just maintain relevance. If you are losing relevance, be careful. You are getting out of purpose. You know what they call relevance? How many of you know what they mean by relevance? You are relevant. When you are out of purpose, you just begin to lose relevance. You begin to lose. Now, that's one of the symptoms to show. God told him, when he wanted, Billy Graham wanted to build a school, God said, he doesn't need to build a school. He said, oh, I'm sorry. And he came back to John 3:16. And every time he preaches John 3:16, it is with fresh fire. It is as if nobody ever preached before. Now, when Bishop Oyedepo got the certificate to begin Covenant University, he went back to God. He said, God, if you are not the one, and I pretended to hear you, now by yourself, tell me now. I won't waste time. I will tear this certificate and nobody can bully me. Because I am the one who went to Nigerian University Commission to take this certificate. Can I hear you? And the Lord said, it is I. Three words. It is I. It is I. And if you look at the school, it is making waves. That's how you know when purpose is on track. It blazes the trail. So your success is tied to your purpose. And if you don't discover and pursue purpose, you are not qualified for God's inheritance. You can find that out in Ephesians 3, verse 11. Why do I need to discover purpose? I give you four reasons why you need to discover purpose. Number one, God gives you his purpose for you. Not your purpose for yourself. His purpose for you. To express his image. In Genesis chapter 1 verse 26, and God said, let us make man in our own image and in our own likeness, and let man have dominion on the face of the earth. So God's primary essence for giving you a purpose is to express his image through you. Think with authority. I am God's express image. Hebrews chapter 1 verse 1 to 3. God, who at sundry times spoken unto us by his prophet, as in this last day spoken unto us by his son, who is the express image of his person and the brightness of his glory. To express his image through you. So when you see yourself, don't reflect God. Something is wrong with your purpose. Can I ask you a question? Do you reflect God right now? That popular comedian says, brotherly, in whose image are you like you are now? Are you in the image of yourself or you are in the image of God? You know you can be in the image of yourself when you are full of yourself, proud, arrogant, you think you know it all. Number two, God gives you purpose to be able to dominate the earth. Genesis 1:28. But it is unfortunate. When you see a man who has lost purpose, you will see the earth dominate the man. Do you believe that? God gives you purpose to be able to dominate the earth. When you see a man who has lost purpose, the earth will dominate him. That thing made out of wood will enter his head. You know the thing made out of wood? Huh? Money. That thing made out of wood will dominate his head. And he'll be going to alcoholism, going to drug addiction, homosexuality, lesbianism. Those are functions of men without purpose. You can't see a man with purpose in his right mind just taking cocaine. Why? Do I need cocaine to be high now? But I'm blasting.
I know what it takes to be high. I'm very high.
Men who have lost sense of reason, they need alcohol to be able to become brave. That is, it's a man who has lost dominion that needs alcohol to be brave. What I will tell you, I will tell you without taking anything. In fact, the clearer my eyes, the better for me. So I just tell you to your face, hey, we're in here, you are in grace. Amen to that. Number three, God gives you purpose to be able to reproduce yourself and impact your environment. To be able to reproduce yourself and impact your environment. Reproduce yourself and impact your environment. Number four, God gives you purpose to be able to enjoy fellowship with Him. God gives you purpose to be able to enjoy fellowship with Him. And I close with this scripture, 2 Timothy 1, 9 and 10. 8 and 9, sorry. To be able to enjoy fellowship with Him. Are you there? 2 Timothy 1, 8. Please look up. One day I think we need to do an exam in this church. And all this your note, we will take the note and we'll set an exam for you, give you blank paper to write on all you learned. And then you will see some mysterious things that people will write that day. People will write some heavenly revelation, give it to them alone. Even some people's paper you can't even read. Because by the time you are reading it, you will fall into trance. Because the things written there, according to St. John, cannot be uttered with human voice. Look up here. 2 Timothy 1, 8. Be not thou therefore ashamed of our Lord, of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me, his prisoner. But be thou partaker of the afflictions of the gospel according to the power of God. Verse 9. Who has saved us and called us with an holy calling, not according to our works, so it is not by effort, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was given us in Christ Jesus. Where? Before. So you see, it's about discovery. It's about election. Did you hear what he said in Romans chapter 9, verse 11? Jacob, I love. Esau, I hate. God, are you wicked? No. He said it is an election according to purpose. Okay. Who are not? If you read to verse 17, he said, then why should God judge anybody? Why should God condemn anybody? If, because nobody can resist his will. Is that correct? But the Bible tells us, he told even Pharaoh, for this purpose, did I make you? To make my power known in you. So God made Pharaoh to kill Pharaoh and show to the world that God killed it and make it alive. Can you blame God that God made me a pastor? Try to be one and see. If you carry the load I carry for 1 year, you survive. God has not called me. You just be sleeping one day, see your heart just fly away from your chest. Because why? It's true. But if God has made you or called you, it gives you the shock absorbers to contain what goes with your assignment. When God calls you to be a businesswoman, all your brain is business. If God did not create you to be a businesswoman and you try to make yourself a businesswoman, you will fail. Because what you bought at 1 naira, you will sell it at 30 kobo. It's true, because you don't. It's not in you. Business is in you. You don't know? Business is in you. Everything you do is in you. You don't learn it. It's not an art you learn. It's divine election. I pray this day for you that the Holy Spirit, as you take this communion today, will open your eyes to see the truth about the purpose why God made you on the face of the earth in the name of Jesus. Rise on your feet, everybody.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the Lord.
Lord God Almighty. Yes, yes. Raise your voice and say,
hallelujah.
Sing.
Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty.
Yes, yes. Sing.
Hallelujah.